stage area in Houma. Travis?
Good evening.
That's right, Norman. Coast Guard members, as well as this private company, ES&H, and members of the oil company, Black Elk, have met here throughout the course of the day. As you and Camille just mentioned, the search continues, but emergency workers have been coming back through the course of the night. And one of those emergency workers gave us some very new video that you're about to see here. This is new video just given to WDSU News by an emergency worker who spent all day on the Gulf of Mexico trying to battle that platform fire. You can see boats in the water spraying that platform with water, trying to get the blaze under control. All afternoon, emergency workers arrived back at ES&H Environmental Services, a private company contracted to help skim oil off the Gulf of Mexico and aid in the search and rescue efforts. The Coast Guard says the platform is intact.
The rig is structurally sound.
The platform is owned by Black Elk Energy out of Houston, Texas. They also have an office in New Orleans. That company has had little to say so far, but the Coast Guard believes the fire broke out when a crew member performing maintenance work cut an oil line with an acetylene torch.
They were using a torch to cut a 3-inch line that was approximately 75 feet long.
The platform is 56 feet deep and was not actively in operation or producing oil. But oil was on the rig.
The environmental threat, as we know, there was 28 gallons that potentially were in that 3-inch line, 75 feet long, which would equate to approximately 28 gallons of product. As of right now, they're reporting an oil sheen in the area, 1/2 mile long by 200 yards.
And once again, check out this video from earlier this morning given to us by an emergency worker. You can see just how serious this fire on that oil platform actually was. We also want to mention that Black Elk and ES&H have two skimmer boats in the water near this platform trying to soak up any oil that is leaking from that rig. Reporting on your side in Houma, Louisiana, I'm Travers Mackel, WDSU News.
Okay, Travers, with that update, we should also add the Bureau of Safety and Environmental Enforcement is investigating the explosion, and the Coast Guard is assisting as